The Defense Research and Development Organization successfully test-fired the Pralay missile from the Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam Island in Odisha. The Ministry of Defense in a statement said that the indigenously developed surface-to-surface missile hit the designated target with high accuracy. This is a ballistic missile with a strike range of about 350 to 500 kilometers. Pralay adds to the long list of weapon systems like the Agni Prime and the BrahMos supersonic cruise missile, among others, successfully tested by the Defense Research and Development Organization this year. India successfully test fires the surface-to-surface Pralay missile. In a big boost to Prime Minister Narendra Modi's Atmanirbhar Bharat in defense manufacturing pitch, the Defense Research and Development Organization test-fired the indigenously developed missile with a range of up to 500 kilometers. The DRDO in a statement said that the missile met all its objectives during the maiden flight test from the Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam Island off the coast of Odisha on Wednesday. The Ministry of Defense in a statement said Pralay followed the desired Kasi ballistic trajectory and reached the designated target with high accuracy. The government said the test validates the missile's control, guidance and mission systems. The sensors deployed near the impact point across the eastern coast tracked and captured all the events. Pralay is powered by a solid propellant rocket motor and has a range of between 350 to 500 kilometers. Pralay can be launched from a mobile launcher. The missile guidance system includes state-of-the-art navigation system and integrated avionics. Pralay comes with a payload capacity of 500 to 1,000 kilograms. The 333 crore rupee project was sanctioned in March 2015 and is expected to give a big impetus to the armed forces.
This test of Pralay is a very happy event. These technologies have matured and it is in the very well in the grip of the Indian scientific community, especially DRDO scientists from Hyderabad.
Raksha Mantri Rajnath Singh congratulated the Defense Research and Development Organization scientists and the team. He complimented DRDO for the fast-track development and successful launch of the surface-to-surface missile. The DRDO has conducted several successful tests of multiple missile systems this year. The new generation nuclear-capable ballistic missile Agni Prime was tested on the 18th of December. The air version of BrahMos supersonic cruise missile was test-fired on the 8th of December. Vertical launch short-range surface-to-air missile on the 7th of December. And Abhyas, the high-speed expendable aerial target, was successfully flight-tested on the 22nd of October.
Equipping the armed forces with modern equipment is critical to their success in any battle as and when that occurs. And this becomes more and more important due to ongoing standoff between India and China.
Pralay missile also has the ability to change its flight path after covering a certain range mid-air.
Over the last few months, DRDO has been carrying out back-to-back tests of various missiles, and the frequency of these tests has also enhanced. This is to make sure that there is a big boost to India's firepower to take on any threat. With camera person Sanjeev, Abhishek Bhalla in New Delhi for India Today.
And India Today's executive editor Shiv Arur now joins me for more on this big story. Shiv, Pralay successfully test fired today, but there have been a series of missile tests by the Defense Research and Development Organization. Is there not very subtle messaging that's happening here to India's adversaries?
Well, Gaurav, the Pralay is only the latest in what has been a furious series of missile tests over the last 45 days by the DRDO. It's something that we've actually seen in the last, 14 to 15 months since the standoff with China actually began. Of course, I'm not going to relate it directly only to that. These are all scheduled missile tests as part of separate, guided missile programs, and they have to happen at their own pace. But of course, there is an urgency that has come in because of the operational scenario that India faces vis-a-vis China and all the other threats as well. So that's perhaps why we're seeing, many of these tests actually bunched together. Weather, optimal, conditions for these tests also play a major factor. So that's perhaps one thing. The Pralay missile, is a very important one because the images we see today, Gaurav, are actually the first images we're seeing of the Pralay. It's a short-range ballistic missile. India has always had the liquid-fueled Prithvi series of missiles, but the solid-fueled Pralay is going to be in many ways something that takes things many generations ahead. These missiles can be stored longer. It's a quasi-ballistic missile, which means it doesn't have a purely ballistic path. There are many different kinds of warheads that can actually be integrated with this weapon. And for many years between Pakistan, China and India, tactical and short-range ballistic missiles has been a place where India has lacked. And Pralay in many ways actually fills that gap. So it's a big entry into the Indian armed forces in the next couple of years.
Shiv, stay with me. So from filling the gap to being miles ahead, and that's the big news story we've all been waiting for. Braving the threat of US sanctions, India went ahead and began to acquire the S-400 missile defense systems for the Indian Air Force. So the S-400 Triumph, NATO name Growler, that's begun to arrive in India, and the first system has been deployed in Punjab. The complex missile system has a number of radars that can scan the skies up to 600 kilometers away and launch missiles to take down any incoming aerial threat 400 kilometers away. Manjeet Singh Negi gets us much more on the system that's being called a real game changer.
The Triumph is here. S-400, one of the best air defense systems in the world, now arrives in India. Aimed at neutralizing any aerial threat on both its western and eastern fronts, India will soon field the first S-400 air defense system in the Punjab sector.
पाकिस्तान के अंदर जितना एयर स्पेस है उसको हम लोग पूरा कवर कर सकते हैं और अगर पाकिस्तान समझ रहा है कि वो पीछे अफगानिस्तान को भी पकड़ के अपने एरोप्लेन्स और एवैक सिस्टम को उस तरफ करे तो 600 किलोमीटर रेंज से भारत वहां तक भी पहुंच सकता है और चीन के पास रशिया बस 250 किलोमीटर तक का मैक्सिमम रेंज वाला दे सकता है.
The S-400 Triumph is a mobile surface-to-air missile system capable of engaging aircraft, drones, and even slow-moving cruise missiles. The state-of-the-art air defense system also has terminal ballistic missile defense capabilities. The S-400 comes with a multifunction radar, autonomous detection and targeting systems, and a command and control center. The missile system is capable of taking on practically any aerial target within a range of 400 kilometers and can simultaneously engage up to 36 targets. India signed the $5.43 billion deal with Russia in October 2018 for 5 S-400 Triumph regiments, despite objections from the United States.
It is like a booster dose. Both the Rafale deal and the S-400 are like a booster dose to the IF, whose numbers are coming now.
So what has upset the Americans? All in all, the Russian S-400 is today the most sophisticated air defense platform and costs around half of its Western equivalents, including Lockheed Martin's Terminal High Altitude Air Defense System, or THAAD. In 2020, the US imposed CATSA, Countering America's Adversaries Through Sanctions Act, on Turkey for buying the same air defense system from Russia. During his visit to India earlier this year, US Defense Secretary Lloyd Austin had hinted that India's planned purchase of the Russian missile system could trigger US sanctions.
While Pakistan doesn't have such an advanced defense system, China has acquired the same weapon from Russia and deployed on the line of actual control. So the S-400 acquisition is a key to India's defense preparedness, not just vis-a-vis Pakistan, but also China. This is Manjit Negi for India Today.
Let me once again bring in India Today's Shiv Arur for more on this. Shiv, Pakistan would be deeply concerned. I mean, Pakistan has nothing that will come anywhere close to this, but China too has deployed the S-400 systems on their side of the line of actual control. So what does this actually mean for the Indian Air Force? And does China having the same system before us somehow diminish some of our advantage?
You know, the word game changer is used very often, Gaurav, so I'm going to be a little careful when I use this, especially since even though the S-400 has now arrived in India and will over the next few months be deployed and operationalized, the truth is, like you've been reporting, that the S-400 is already functional and active, you know, with the Chinese military. They've got S-400 systems active not very far from the line of actual control itself. So one needs to wonder whether if both adversaries have the same air defense system, what kind of game changer will that be? Having said that, given the functions of the S-400, given the aerial threats, the huge amount of emphasis that China has placed on trying to match up with India's aviation capabilities, bolstering its helicopter ports, more aircraft deployed near the Tibetan plateau, building new airfields, all of this means that China is putting a great emphasis on aviation, and therefore having the S-400 on the Indian side is always going to be of enormous significance, because this is a weapon system that can engage at very long distances in excess of 400 kilometers. It can engage multiple targets. All the aircraft in China's inventory, helicopters, drones, armed drones, cruise missiles, all of those are potential targets for the S-400 system. So in that sense, if you look at it purely in terms of a bean count or a geography versus geography situation, which is quite complicated usually, the S-400 in India is definitely going to be very, very important as far as India's capability against China is concerned.
Shiv, for the moment, many thanks. The fact that we have the S-400 systems means that the enemy will think twice before they try anything foolhardy. Let's now move to the other story. So there's a lot of pressure and push for Atmanirbhar Bharat. Yes, we have the S-400 Triumphs that have come from Russia. Yes, we have the best aircraft that are coming in, the Rafales from France. But India is also doing a lot for Atmanirbhar Bharat in defense manufacturing, and hundreds lined up to get a glimpse of India's frontline battle tanks at an expo organized by the Armored Vehicles Nigam Limited at Tamil Nadu in Avadi. From T-90 Bhishma to Arjun Mark 1, these mean machines were on display for the people of our country to take a look at the weapons that our armed forces have, and also to celebrate Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav, commemorating 75 years of India's independence. India Today is Pramod Madhav got an opportunity to get up close to these weapon systems. We bring you this report.
From state-of-the-art tanks to their components, hundreds got a rare opportunity to experience India's mean war machines in Tamil Nadu's Avadi. India's frontline battle tanks featured at the exhibition organized by Armored Vehicles Nigam Limited. On the display were Ajay T-72. Bhishma T-90 tanks and completely made in India Arjun MK-1 tanks.
We are standing on one such magnanimous a kind of iron beast called as Arjun MK-1 that was designed and created in India, a symbol of Make in India as well. And here in this place, you could see the various other tanks as well. On behind, you could see that one is T-90 Bhishma. On the other side, you have T-72 tank as well. And on there you have to our left side, the bridge laying tank. These are all various machines that are produced in Avadi Tank Factory, and that's the reason they are showcasing all these machines used by our brave soldiers here.
And these long lines outside the expo gives an indication of the crowd it attracted.
The main purpose of organizing this exhibition is to bring a sense of pride in the general public about the advancement which has taken place in the country over the last 75 years. And it's a step towards the Atmanirbhar Bharat. We are displaying many items which can be made further in India. As of now, we are importing.
India today got a chance to get inside an indigenous Arjun MK1 tank.
And as we are entering the place where the four-member crew will sit, the driver will be in the front, the loader on this side. This is the gunner, and also the commanding officer will sit over here. This is actually how it looks inside an Arjun MK1 tank. Sir, can you tell us about this particular tank's specialty?
It's a gunner main sight. It's got day and night. दोनों सही से फोकस करके 4 किलोमीटर तक हम विजिबल देख सकते हैं इसके थ्रू हमने फायर भी कर सकते हैं ये LRF है उसका फोकसिंग सिस्टम चीज है एकदम क्वालिटी में
Here you have, this is a place where the actual shells will be kept. This is a world-renowned tank where you can actually use several rounds. Could it be sabot rounds? Could it be heat rounds? Everything can be used on this tank. And this is a part where the actual shell will be loaded into, and the gunner will have the controls. And once the commanding officer gives the order, the gunner will shoot.
The exhibition celebrates Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav, commemorating 75 years of independence. Many such events have been planned throughout the year to celebrate the momentous occasion. With Pramod Madhav in Tamil Nadu, Bureau Report, India Today.
So let's now move on from the threat at our borders to the threat amidst us, the threat of the Omicron variant of the coronavirus. And the threat is rising, and how Prime Minister Narendra Modi will chair a crucial meeting on Thursday to review India's COVID situation and preparedness. The centre has already sounded an alert and directed state governments not just to be vigilant, but also to have systems and standard operating procedures in place to deal with the threat of an outbreak. So just days before party season, curbs are back. Gatherings have been banned not just in the national capital, Delhi, but also in the financial capital, Mumbai, and in Bengaluru. Beware, this threat of the Omicron variant of coronavirus is real.
A super mutant variant, another looming COVID wave, steadily climbing tally. A concerned government is now stepping up the Omicron fight. Prime Minister Narendra Modi is to hold a big review meeting on Thursday. The centre has also issued directives to states to step up measures to contain the Omicron spread, advising states to set up war rooms, impose night curfews if needed, and carry out door-to-door contact tracing and searches. The centre has also asked states to enforce home isolation and accelerate measures to ensure 100% vaccination. Delhi Disaster Management has banned all kinds of functions in view of Christmas and New Year. While parties themselves are banned, strangely, 200 people are being allowed to attend marriages and other such functions at the same time. The Delhi government has also imposed curbs on large gatherings and restricted seating capacity in restaurants to 50%. These curbs will remain in place till the end of the year.
Due to the rising Omicron cases, the DDMA has extended its pre-implemented COVID curbs till the 31st of December, due to which restaurants will still have to operate at a 50% capacity and large gatherings continue to be prohibited along with all religious gatherings.
Restrictions have also been imposed in Mumbai, where parties on terraces and beaches have been banned. However, Mumbaikars will be allowed to hold indoor parties with 50% capacity. Gatherings with 25% capacity are allowed in open areas. Special approval will also be required for a gathering of over 1,000 people.
DMC officials is also saying that it is keeping an eye on the situation. If continuous rise in the Omicron cases are there in the city, then more stricter curbs can be applied.
The Karnataka government, meanwhile, has also imposed a ban on mass gatherings. Restaurants and bars will only be allowed to function with a 50% customer capacity. No special events or DJ parties are being allowed anywhere in the state of Karnataka. Tourists who've been flocking to Goa in the holiday season will face an imposition of Section 144, which prevents gatherings of more than 3 people.
The state government has also been asking people to adhere to social distancing norms and wear masks at all times. Many of these rules across cities and tourist destinations in the country could intensify in the days ahead. India Today will keep you updated. Bureau Report, India Today.
There is now a big debate raging on the need for booster shots. Should India start giving booster shots to the healthcare workers and frontline workers, vulnerable population, or should the priority remain the second dose for all adult Indians? In the middle of this raging debate, there is a political fight that's erupted. Rahul Gandhi, Congress party leader, questioned India's vaccine policy. He questioned the center on why booster shots were not being given. The center, of course, on their part, has maintained the need, timing and nature of booster shots will depend on scientific consensus and not politics.
The Omicron variant is spreading fast, making even fully vaccinated vulnerable, making breakthrough infection increasingly common. While fully vaccinated, healthy individuals can still count on evading hospitalization due to Omicron, the demand for a booster dose for enhanced protection is gaining momentum. The Congress has asked the government to ensure booster vaccination, with party MP Rahul Gandhi stressing on the need. Rahul claimed that India will fail to meet the 60% vax coverage target by December and will end up with just 42% full vaccination.
Of course, everyone knows it spreads much faster than Delta variant, but it's not clear on how severe it is. The current vaccines are not necessarily working with this variant. So we have to be careful on how we are thinking about vaccinating and also get ready to accept that we might have to vaccinate everybody else again for this variant with a new booster.
Why is the government taking so long to come up with an official stance? Are they for booster doses? Are they for vaccines for children? Yes or no? Why are they taking so long?
The government has accused the opposition of spreading misinformation on vaccines. Many states have already mounted a demand for booster COVID vaccinations, especially states which are on the verge of meeting full vaccination targets.
हम चाहते हैं कि अब बूस्टर डोज अलाउ की जाए, इस बारे में केंद्र सरकार परमिशन देता है, तो मेरी केंद्र सरकार से निवेदन है कि जो जो लोग दो डोज ले चुके हैं, उनको बूस्टर डोज देने की इजाजत दी जाए।
मैंने बूस्टर डोज के लिए सबसे पहले आवाज उठाई है देश के अंदर कि बूस्टर डोज का टाइम आ गया, आज 9 महीने हो गए, 7 साल हो गए फर्स्ट डोज लगे हुए। जो बीमार है 60 प्लस उम्र के हैं, ये बीमार है, उन सबके प्रायोरिटी में बूस्टर डोज लगनी चाहिए। अभी कोई स्कीम नहीं है भारत सरकार योजना में नहीं।
The government on its part has indicated that vaccinating all with two doses remains its priority, awaiting expert views or a possible booster.
As we have said and as the Honorable Health Minister Sahab has said in the Parliament, the need and the timing and the nature of boosting, if any, will be based on scientific decisions, scientific thinking, and that is what the government is engaged with.
The opposition also questioned political rallies being organized despite the Omicron threat.
हमने सेकेंड वेव भी देखा था, देश में इतनी बुरी तरीके से फैला था, उससे कुछ सीख सीख कर पॉलिटिकल रैलीज इन सब पे किसी तरीके का नियंत्रण लाया जाएगा।
अभी यूपी का चुनाव है, बड़ी रैलियां करना है, लोग मरे तो मरे, राम का मरे, रहीम का मरे, मोदी की वोट बैंक भरे।
Amid forecasts of a spike in the number of COVID cases, there's renewed interest in the booster shot for those already vaccinated. Private hospitals are flooded with requests for the booster dose following reports that boosters are being administered abroad. Bureau Report, India Today.
The situation is grim. You need to mask up. You need to follow COVID appropriate behavior. All of us need to do that. That is all I have for you on India First this evening. Many thanks for watching. Coming up next is Udayan Mukherjee on Business Today.